왜냐면 못 나오게 했어요. 그냥 방에서.
방에서?
예.
근데 그 초등학생이 거기 5시간 앉아있다는 게 진짜
안 죽어요.
Watching this video made me sick. I just watched a video that my friend sent about a Korean mom interviewing other Korean moms about how they educate their children and raise their children.
저도 이제 학습식 영유를 보냈는데 네, 네. 저희 애는 네. 6개월 만에 번아웃이 오더라고요.
네. 7살 때요?
아니요. 5세 때.
5세 때? 5세 때 번아웃은 어떤 형태로 오던 거예요?
정말 그게 오는데 어떻게 왔냐면 방해를 못 들어가고요.
본인 방에?
네, 방에 감옥 갔다고 하면서.
5살이?
네.
어떡해.
그래서 원래 그림 그리는 것도 좋아했는데 이제 색연필도 못 잡고 그게 너무 심해져서 이제 6개월 다니다가 나왔거든요. 나오고 이제 놀이식 영유를 갔는데 네. 다니고 일주일 차에 저한테 네. 구해줘서 고맙다 그런 거예요.
아이고.
But that was the only positive story within the entire video that I watched. The other moms said that when their children hit puberty, they become more difficult to deal with, like not doing what they're told and closing their rooms and shutting themselves off when they get into an argument. So what they do is before they hit puberty,
제가 대치동에 이사 오면서 네. 애들 방에 문을 안 달았어요.
그러니까 문이 이런 식으로 그냥 뚫려
네네 원룸이에요 저 이제.
그냥 네, 방 문을 다 뗐어요.
아 진짜요? 그럼 아이들이 반발하지 않아요? 아니 프라이버시는 지켜줘야지.
초등 6학년 때 떼고 들어온 거잖아요. 네. 네, 그때 이제 좋아 막 이렇게 합의가 됐었어요. 그때는. 그러니까 뭐 지금 3학 방문 떼기 딱 좋은 시기예요.
아 진짜요?
바로 지금입니다.
지금 네, 네, 방문 떼기 네.
제가 알기로는 네. 네, 대치동에서는 많이 떼요. 우리 딸만 해도 어릴 때는 이제 뭐 몰랐으니까 네. 아무 말 안 했는데 네. 이제 사춘기 오고 하니까 네. 아 제발 커튼이라도 좀 달아달라고.
아 이 집도 집 문이 없어요?
네네네. 네, 네. 왜냐면 못 나오게 했어요. 그냥 방에서.
방에서?
예. 어차피 문은 없으니까 보이잖아요 다. 그러니까
근데 그 초등학생이 거기 5시간 앉아있다는 게 진짜
안 죽어요.
A mom said, make your children think that it's an obvious thing. Of course I have to study. That's the only thing that I should be doing right now. Of course. Make them think that way. That was their strategy.
그냥 아이가 당연한 거라고 생각하게끔. 예, 예.
그러면 어머님들은 아이들이 어떻게 자랐으면 좋겠어요?
제가 솔직하게 말할게요. 네. 저희 아들이 네. 공부도 잘하고 네. 운동도 잘하고 네. 좀 인싸형으로 성격도 좋고 일단 키도 180 이상 아, 네, 네. 커서 그런 아들이었으면 솔직히 좋겠어요. 그렇죠. 그렇게 되잖아요. 얘도 자신감이 차서 그렇지. 여자도 더 잘 보시고.
But do you think that they're gonna be such a well-rounded person when they're just studying for hours and hours every single day? So I have a friend who actually used to teach as a 학원 teacher, you know, this cram school teachers, and he would teach kids that were about 10 years old, and the kids would ask him, like, does your family pay rent or does your family own your own place? And he heard in advance, before the kids asked any of that, from fellow teachers, if the kids ask you anything, if they pay rent or if you own your house or any other money related questions, just play along and say, oh yeah, yeah, of course, we own our own place. Play the part that you have a lot of money, whether or not you actually do. And I was thinking, first of all, at 10 years old, I didn't know what rent was. And second, why the fuck are they asking that? They're so judgy. Like, they literally look down on people who are paying rent. They're like, oh, your family's so poor, what a loser. That's not all. One day, one student asked him out of the blue, 쌤, 돈 없어요? Teacher, are you poor? And he was baffled by that. And he was like, why do you asked that question. And the kid was like, well, you're wearing the same similar clothes all the time. They're not fancy clothes, they're just like comfortable clothes. Makes me think that you don't have any money. And my friend responded, well, I just don't really care about looking fancy or spending a lot of money on clothes, so I don't really care about that, that's why. But my friend had a Rolex in his house because he was into watches, he just wasn't wearing it. So the next day he put on his Rolex and he went to teach the kids, and the kids just started like, wow, isn't that a Rolex? That's the one my dad's been trying to get, but he couldn't get. How do you have that? And he said it wasn't even just all the boys who knew, all the girls knew that it was a Rolex as well. how do these 10-year-old kids know what a Rolex looks like? Like, I'm 33, I have no idea what a Rolex looks like. These kids can tell, like, oh, that's a Rolex, that's a Patek Philippe, that's Omega. Like, they're 10 years old. They're so judgy, man. They really look down on you if you're poor. If you have money, suddenly you're higher in their eyes. I grew up in Korea from kindergarten to end of elementary school. And I went to some cram schools, Hagwon. I went to English Hagwon. I also got math tutors, writing tutors. And yes, there were times it sucked and I was like sad that I couldn't get to do some of the things that I wanted to do, like watch Dragon Ball Z. But at the same time, I don't remember feeling completely overwhelmed and depressed. But my level of childhood of what I experienced doesn't even seem comparable to what the kids in Korea are experiencing now. And my friend who sent me this video, who's raising her daughter in Korea, said that people in Korea seem to be getting more weird, more inconsiderate, and more selfish. And that's one person's opinion. I don't know if that's actually true. If you are living in Korea and you're watching this, let me know in the comments what you think about that. But my friend was saying the reason she thinks that's happening is because of Korea's fucked up education system. And even hearing that story of my friend teaching these 10-year-old kids, I don't know if they're a super small sample of Koreans and other Korean kids are not like that, or if quite a lot of Korean kids are like that. But regardless, that's so fucked up. I hope that changes over time, but looking at it right now, it doesn't seem like it's gonna change for the better anytime soon. Reviewing the past few days, I did calf raises for the first time 3 days ago at the gym, and holy shit, 100 pounds of calf raises, 10 sets, and I cannot stand or walk right now. Oh, I gotta work on my calves. I will see you in 2 days. 1% better every day, baby.
Tigger enjoying the outdoors. Tigger. Watch it.
This is Tigger before the brushing, and this is Tigger after some brushing.